Hey guys, it's Captain Harris back for another video. Recently, I say recently, it was like 4 months ago, I came across a website that has nearly every single piece of Bruce Dickinson's wardrobe from this recent tour, minus the sexy see-through tank top.
So you're telling me that the Bruce Dickinson from Iron Maiden has purchased his future past outfit online?
I don't know that he has, but the band has. And I thought that was really interesting because I know a lot of their pieces in the past were custom made. And now it's like anybody can go buy literally the entire outfit, but it's really expensive. And I think you should all take a look at the about section. Like, I'm not going to read it off. Just go surprise yourself. Read the about section on the website.
I haven't seen it in months, so this is a refresher for me.
Well, you don't need it. I'm going to leave it. I'm not going to read it off. I'm going to let the audience decide if they'd like to go read it. Just tell me in the comments what you think. What this has to do with a
We're not going to read any of it?
It's so long. Okay. I'm going to start screen recording here. I'm just going to show y'all. I don't want to read all of this nonsense.
Pick a random sentence. Just read that one.
Ancient traditions not only recognize this relationship, they invite us to take... They invite us one step further, and they left precise instructions in terms of how we apply this in our lives. In the late 1980s, I was an engineer working in the defense and aerospace corporations.
This is a clothing
website. Clothing website. I want y'all to go read. Look, it keeps going. So yeah, go have a good time and read that. But that's not the topic of today's video. Because I came across this and it was a very, very expensive website, wanted to do a fun little video that was a steal their look. So we're going to steal Bruce Dickinson's wardrobe look from the Future Past Tour and from the Mandrake Project. And we're also going to steal Steve Harris's look that hasn't really changed much from tour to tour, but we'll still do like the recent tour. So anyways, we will start with Bruce on demobaza.com. And so this came about because I really wanted those glasses to wear like to the tour. This was like an outfit I felt like I could recreate, but I wanted like the boots and the glasses and stuff. So I was trying to find a dupe and I came across the actual ones. So
you found the visors.
Yes. All right, so we have several colors of these glasses, and they are $202.64. And I understand sunglasses can get expensive, but sunglasses that look like this?
They look great. I don't know what you mean.
I couldn't justify spending $200 on a pair of glasses that I was going to be wearing to concerts. That looks like them, so we'll add that to our bag. And we have his pants. You guys are going to be shocked by the price of some of this stuff. Let me know in the comments. Is somebody going to buy this outfit and wear it to the show? Because that would be really cool.
Or
if
Halloween.
If you had the money. It's far too expensive.
Too much for Halloween.
I'll start a crowdfunder. All right. There's those bad boys. A cool $469 for his pants.
That's a bit more than I thought. I was expecting like $200 again.
Oh, no. You are going to be shocked by the prices. So, we'll do a medium.
I think Bruce is a small.
He's a small, but they don't have small left.
He has to wear a belt.
It doesn't matter. They're all the same price. All right. We're already at $671.
They are gorgeous.
I do like this outfit. I like it more for the Mandrake Project than I do the Future Past. I was kind of hoping for more of a Blade Runner look for this tour, but it's still pretty cool. Just not my favorite. All right, the shoes. These. Mm. You're going to barf.
Okay, let me prepare.
$639.
Not per shoe.
Like, they are really cool, but like, they're like maybe $200 cool in my opinion. That's just, it's insane.
This is out of my class.
Oh yeah, like my middle class mind can't comprehend.
Mm-hmm.
They are genuinely very cool shoes. It's my favorite part of the outfit is those, but never in my life could I pay that much money for a pair of shoes. Look at this.
What is that?
This website just has some of the weirdest shit I've ever seen.
I mean, this is what the cast of Dune wore.
Well, it's kind of supposed to be emulating that, I think.
I see.
They have a Dune collection, actually.
Of course they do.
All right. Price?
Is it just the vest?
Just the vest.
$844? Yes. For a vest? Yes. What's it made of? Silver?
It's everything on this website seems to be made of, like, worn denim. He's a nice small. We'll get a little small. Okay. That is, I forgot how much that one was. I hadn't looked at that in a while.
Oh my god. Bruce is shelling out.
Yeah, it makes me a little bit sad because y'all know that I'm like obsessed with the like stage wear for bands and Maiden in general. And like the story of like how they put together the Somewhere on Tour outfit was just like so cool. It's like it's a custom made piece that I just assumed this was too, and unfortunately it's not. Any bozo can go spend $5,000.
Well, not any bozo. A bozo with a lot of...
Well, yeah, if you got a credit card.
Nah, but who has those?
Everyone. Okay, this is actually on discount. It's the top coat. So you're actually getting a deal with this.
Getting a bargain.
It is half off at $587. Normally, $1,175.
That's a steal.
It's cheaper than the vest.
I mean, you're robbing them blind at that price.
Taking half of it off. For it's sold out. We're going to have to add that at the end.
Yeah, you wouldn't think they'd be running those deals if it was sold out.
Yeah.
The demand is high.
Right, I'm going to have to write this number down because we'll have to add it, calculate it at the end. Because back when I found the website, this was available. So now you can't steal his look.
Put it on layaway.
$1,000. So much money. Yeah, so you got all your pictures there. He seems to really like that cloak, though, so good for him. He got one before it sold out.
Clearly.
I'm not sure that these are the exact ones he wore because it was kind of hard to find pictures, but it's close enough. One of these, $212. He has two.
So he's got two of them.
He's got one for each arm, so we're going to add two to bag, $400 for some arm cuffs. How much do you think the guys pay for their little sweatbands in bulk? Pennies on the dollar?
Like maybe 70 cents each.
And then resellers go on eBay like $180.
Yeah. And I pull out my wallet and I purchase.
No, we don't. My God. Okay, so that's everything on this website.
Okay.
And I've got one more thing. We're going to add up the total with shipping and this piece that unfortunately they don't have. All right, so I'm going to have to do some conversions because they just converted me to euros. All right, so the last piece that we're going to look up, you can find the sexy see-through tank top for an absolute bargain. It's clearly not going to be the one that he used, but it's very close. So, on the Basic Bitch website, Fashion Nova, you can find a tank top extraordinarily similar to Bruce for only $6.98.
Bargain basement prices.
So you've got a total of $3,218 from Dima Baza and only $6.98 from Fashion Nova for a grand total of Bruce's outfit, whole wardrobe from the Future Past Tour being $3,224. We'll round it up to $225 with the cents.
Worth it, if you ask me. I think it looks great.
I can't believe anybody can just go and buy that stuff.
Right, this looks like something specifically
made for the band.
I was going to say like the Hollywood, yeah. Like the filming industry.
Well, it's funny because I looked, you know, I obviously looked into it and a lot of different performers have used it. Like Janet Jackson had a whole outfit with her backup dancers and everything made by them.
Like recently?
Last few years.
Hmm.
Yeah. So, yeah. All right. Well, I'm going to move on to Steve.
So our choices are you could pay that to be Bruce.
Yes.
Or this is your other choice
I'm going to Walmart.com because Steve's a man's man. He just wears, I guarantee you this stuff is like nothing special, but we're going to base it off of, I will put it up there, this photo.
You can definitely get Steve's outfit at Walmart. He definitely walks right in. He looks right at the greeter and he says,
yeah, cheers, Mike.
Do they have Walmart in the Bahamas?
No.
They have the equivalent, well, whatever.
Do they? I don't know.
I don't know. Never whatever been. The equivalent of Walmart is where Steve lives. Poundland.
Poundland? They don't have Poundland.
If he's in the UK at the time. I don't know. So we're going to start from the bottom with his shoes. We're going to look for black tactical sneakers. He always has these nice, big, chunky sneakers on.
Yep. In case anybody runs on stage again, kick him right off.
See, these. This looks Steve, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. That's so Steve.
Like, if you wanted to emulate Steve's look, some nice trekking shoes. They only have size 10, so we'll have to deal with it.
That sounds about right.
Add to cart. There's some nice, what are those, calf, mid-calf socks? He needs diabetic socks.
They don't have Steve's legs on here?
Big and tall. He's not big or tall, so.
I don't think it matters. I don't think I've ever looked at the size when buying socks. It's just a big old pack and it says socks.
All right. I don't want diabetic. What's the problem? What? Maybe it's...
Those are nice.
There.
That'll do.
Look at that. And you get a multi-pack. They're still diabetic.
It's okay. Maybe he wears the diabetic ones just for fun.
Fine. That's the average price of a pack of socks these days anyway, so. Let's see what else we got. Some nice dark gray.
I own those.
You do. We got those from like Bell's Outlet or some
shit. We got that from a store where
everything goes to die.
It sells things that nobody bought when it was new.
Let's just see a couple scrolls down what we got.
Right there.
Which ones? He's got the lower pockets. He seems to like this style.
That's it. That has Steve written all over it.
I don't know what size he is, but they're all the same.
That's the thing with men's. You know, one size fits all.
Nice. Men's black tank. Simple guy.
Oh, dude, he's jacked.
I mean, it's basically like these, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, just pick
it up. Oh, there we go. Look at that. It's exactly that.
That's probably a multi-pack, too.
They got even a $6 one. He's high class.
He's affluent. He could afford it. A nicer tank top from Walmart.
Oh, it is a 3-pack. See, you're getting multiples.
See, he gets 3 shows in a row.
You're getting the most bang for your buck. I think that's it, other than a couple wristbands, but, like, I don't count that. You can't just buy those at Walmart.
No, you can't get those at Walmart.
So we're going to go to our cart. Wow, only $106.95 if you want to emulate that Steve Harris look with some extra socks and tank tops.
So do you think, like, Steve approved... Do you think, first of all, do you think Maiden paid for Bruce's outfit? Or do you think Bruce was like, this is it, I'm building this myself?
It's hard to say because he's used it for the Mandrake project too. Like, obviously, he's been with the band for ages. Like, it's just Bruce is like a huge part of Maiden. So I don't think they'd be opposed to him using it for the Mandrake project. But I don't know. Like, if he's wearing that on the Mandrake project tour too, I have a feeling it might have been him.
But don't they share management?
I guess they do.
So I bet Bruce came up with this idea and was like, hey, Rod.
You know, $3,000 is nothing for a band.
It's nothing for Rod. Like, that Rod has that in his shoes. So he pulled his shoe out. He gave the money to Bruce.
Sock,
he was
money.
Like, I'm going to use this for Maiden and maybe the Mandrake project. So expensive. Steve's a businessman. Bruce is...
Well,
is a crazy person.
Bruce is a performer.
He's a performer.
And he likes to have his tools to perform, like costumes and props and things like that.
Well, Steve, if you were to see any live footage of Bruce putting a Spartan hat on Steve. Steve doesn't like costumes.
He
Steve threw it off his head. No, he wants to wear tank tops and shorts, and he wants to know that I got a good deal.
I miss the Steve Harris jeans days. Last we saw that
2009.
Yeah,
we haven't seen jeans since then, and even before then, like Rock and Rio.
I'd love to see a little more variation, like even just like a print on the tank top, like the Whale Will Be Fooked one. And,
I know, we don't even get that anymore.
And he had like the one with the space print for Final Frontier. Now it's just been plain black tank tops. Like, I want to see some color. Yeah, some tiny Steve variation.
Maybe he takes Adrian's scarf, or could you imagine Steve with a headband?
I mean, even this. Adrian, you know, he's got his headbands and he's got his cool jeans and stuff. This was like $20 online, and this is the same exact shirt. Like, it's the same place they bought it from and everything. Sold
Adrian.
Yeah. And this was like $20. So, like, even they aren't going like $3,000 outfits or
anything. No, but Bruce is like, I need to compete with the youth.
I need to look like I'm from Dune.
And I think he pulls it off.
Yeah. It's a cool outfit.
It is. Do you think it's too much money, though?
Yes. Absolutely. I think it's too much money. I was so excited when I found the glasses, and I'm like, oh my God, $200. Like, yeah, a lot of different glasses brands have some nicer glasses for that much. But I'm like, it's just like goggles. I'm only going to wear it to the show. I'm not going to wear them anywhere else. And then I saw everything else. I'm like, oh my God.
So I'm wondering if next month we're going to see him come out in this costume again.
I have been wondering that because it's like all the photo shoots and stuff use it. But, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if it was just for the photo shoots. But
yeah, I think when he did the photo shoot, they just came in the mail. And he was like, let me try them on.
Nah, he took that shit home in a suitcase.
Yeah, he and a multiples.
Tour. Just wears it around the house. So.
Actually, I bet there are multiples of it on tour. Like, don't they have to go in the wash and stuff? They can't just wear it after night.
Yeah, but, I mean, there's plenty of time to wash it between shows.
No, there's not. Yes, it's denim.
Yes, it is.
It's denim.
It is.
There's stains.
From what?
You don't want to know.
Oh, my God. Whatever. Anyways, let us know your thoughts on this down below and how shocking the prices are to you, or if we're just poor middle-class people who don't understand fashion.
I'm on Steve's side with this.
Oh, yeah.
Go simple. And then you can just show up to a bar with a bunch of Maiden fans, shake their hands, and buy a beer.
Say cheers.
Nobody notices, you know?
Right. Anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I guess we'll see you next time.
Later.